Reigning R&B, R&B Rainstorm, it's your boy Bobby Flawless, live on Ground Up Radio. Shout outs to my man Q45, Ground Up Radio CEO making big moves. Got the radio station popping now. Yeah, y'all know me. Now, you know, most of y'all know my voice from Celebrity Underrated. And shout outs to all my fans, man. I'm gonna get to y'all in a minute, but you know, sometimes gotta take a break, man. When I take a break, I just sometimes just sit back, listen to a lot of old school R&B music. Usually when it's raining outside and my Wi-Fi acting up, I just sit back, roll up, twist up some good, drink my wine, you know, a liquor, beer, whatever. And just zone out to some throwback R&B music, man. I can't listen to rap music all day no more as I get older. It's crazy. You know, it's all about the ladies, man. You know, when it's raining outside, you don't cook, house is clean, music playing. She say she on her way. It's gonna be a good night, man, you know. Or you just might wanna chill by yourself. But before we start with the show, R&B Rainstorm, I have to take time and just thank all of my fans for the success of my channel reaching 100,000 subscribers. I just want to say thank y'all from the bottom of my heart, especially my day one fans. And believe it or not, I read all the comments. Y'all the reason why I really keep doing this, man. Y'all the reason. So, you know, and there was a lot of obstacles, man, I had to face. And as I get bigger and bigger, there's a lot more coming. But, you know, as long as I got y'all support, we ain't stopping y'all. We about to take this thing to the next level. It's just a lot of stuff, man. I know y'all like to see the images and the pictures and the videos I do, but I think I'm gonna have to stop using those pictures, y'all, ASAP, man. You know, I don't want to get in trouble. I'm trying to do things the right way now. Y'all might just have to listen to the voice. Listen to my voice in the audio. I mean, I can put the pictures up there. It just got to be certain ones, and it might not be that many available. You know, it's just crazy, man. The bigger you get, the more you learn about things, and you know, and shout outs to all my Patreon supporters too, man. Shout outs to all of y'all. I got more exclusive content coming too. But at the end of the day, I just want to say thanks to everybody who loves Celebrity Underrated. Also, I just want to say I make beats too, y'all. I'm a producer. I make beats. And I just released a Celebrity Underrated Instrumentals album. It's called Soundtrack to the Channel, Volume 1, which is available on all platforms right now, iTunes, Spotify, Amazon. I'm going to leave the link in the description if y'all want to buy or stream it. Or y'all can just go to my website and stream it there, whatever. It's called Soundtrack to the Channel, Volume 1, Celebrity Underrated Instrumentals. That's the name of it. There's, you know, some nice, smooth R&B, hip-hop type beats for y'all to just zone out to. And I would love to hear y'all feedback on it. And I got so many new shows for y'all. I'm telling y'all, man. But anyway, now with that out the way, and because I love y'all so much, I'm going to give y'all a preview of the new show, R&B Rainstorm. You know, we just going to chill tonight. Now, tonight's episode is all about songs that really explain to someone that you love them. This is the I Love You episode, part one. There's going to be a lot of parts to this. There's going to be a lot of episodes to it. And I want y'all to put y'all top five I Love You songs in the comments because I need some ideas for part two. Yeah, I want y'all to put y'all songs, y'all top five songs in the comments, you know. I want y'all to do the same thing I'm doing. Just sit back when it's raining and think of all the love songs But anyway, let's get into the first song. Oh man, this is my junk right here. New Bird, Wildflower, on Rain and Soul and R&B.
She's faced the hardest times you could imagine. And many times her eyes fall back the tears, Lord, Lord. And when her useful world was about to fall in, each time her slender shoulders fought the weight of all the fears. And a sorrow no one hears still rings in midnight silence in her ear. Let her cry. Let me hold her for all time. If I allowed just one possession, I would pick her from the garden to be mine. See, I know you have it hard sometimes, but when you feel like you need me, or you can call me, you see, because I'll be somewhere around. You see, not only that, you see, I'll be your bridge over troubled waters. You see, the reason why I say this, baby, is because I love you, girl. I love you so much. Sometimes I can't even explain. You see, you're like a flower that blooms in any season. And that's why I like to say, you're my flower, baby. You're my flower. Ooh, baby, she's a flower. You're my flower. Flower. It's you, baby. It's you. It's you, baby, baby. It's you, baby. It's you.
Raining soul, raining R&B rainstorm, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to call it R&B rainstorm, man. It's your boy Bobby Flawless. We live on Ground Up Radio. Shout outs to my man Q45. You know, that was New Birth with Wildflower. Now, when it comes to the song Wildflower, right, a lot of artists, they remade it and did their version. I think Color Me Bad did it, the OJs, Lisa Fisher, Silk, and a lot more artists, but I don't think nobody did it like this R&B group, New Birth, man. I mean, the song was originally written in 1972 by a Canadian band called Skylark, and it was in the top 10 on the Billboard Hot 100 for 21 weeks, and the guy that wrote it, his name was Dave Richardson, and he said how the song came about was he was dating this girl who worked for a nursing home, and he went to her house to pick her up for a date, but when he got there, she was crying because she had just lost two patients that she was close to, she was taking care of. And after explaining the situation to him, she had went in the room to get ready for the date, but she was so emotionally drained from all the crying, she ended up falling asleep, and he just went in there and put the blanket over her and left the house. That's when he went to the studio and wrote the song in 15 minutes, Wildflower. I like their version too, but the version I used to hear growing up was from New Birth. They put that soul touch on it, and when he get to talking at the end of it, man, he make the ladies go crazy, man. That's that R&B, man, that back in the day R&B. Now, New Birth is actually a bunch of groups put together. It's like 17 members. And they released this song back in 1974 off the album title, It's Been a Long Time. And Wildflower, that song, it reached number 17 on the R&B chart and number 45 on the pop charts. That was a good group, man, New Birth. What was the other song they had? Dream Merchant. I like that one too. But anyway, now, let's get into the next song on R&B Rainstorm. Uh-oh. Shalimar. I know y'all know this. This is for the lover in you. R&B Rainstorm.
Forever.
R&B Rainstorm, Roundup Radio. It's your boy Bobby Flawless, and that was Shalimar with "This Is For The Lover In You." What a classic, man. Now look, that song was written by Howard Hewitt and songwriter Dana Myers, and it was on the Shalimar's 3 for Love album in 1980, which went platinum. And it reached number 17 on the R&B charts. And in 2009, Essence Magazine included the song in their list of the 25 best slow songs of all time. And Jody Watley and Howard Hewitt's voice, man, they blended so good together on that song. You know what's crazy, though? You know the crazy thing about Shalimar is Jody Watley still don't deal with Howard Hewitt and Jeffrey Daniel. After they broke up, the only reunion they had was when Babyface remade the song for his album in 1996, and they all performed it with LL Cool J live on the UK's Top of the Pops show. But that was the first and only live performance together since 1983. Crazy part is, when Babyface shot the video, Jody Watley did her scene digitally because she didn't want to be in the same room as them. And I know she owns the trademark to the group name Shalimar after a big court battle with Dick Griffey and his family. Dick Griffey is another story I need to do. Big influence in the music business, man. Him and Don Cornelius. But you know, a while back I remember Howard Hewitt and Jeffrey Daniel would do shows with their own group, and Jody Watley would do shows with her new members of the group. You know, back in the day, Jody Watley and Jeffrey Daniel, they used to date, but she said he became mentally and physically abusive to her, and I also heard he dumped her and married Stephanie Mills. Because you know, Jody Watley and Jeffrey Daniel started off on Soul Train together as dancers, and was handpicked by Don Cornelius for the group Shalimar. But you know, Jody and Howard Hewitt both had good solo careers too after the group broke up. But I think Jody's career probably has been the most successful, with Grammys and all types of awards. And hopefully they can patch things up and release another album together in the future. I love Shalimar's music, man. It was dope. But anyway, now, let's get to the next song for the I Love You episode now. Oh man, I know y'all know this. Etta James. We're going to talk about her after the song. Now I'm listening to R&B Rainstorm. It's your boy Bobby Flawless.
Oh yeah, you smile. in heaven. For you are mine at last.
Raining R&B, R&B Rainstorm, Rain Soul. It's your boy Bobby Flawless, live on Ground Up Radio. That was Etta James with At Last. That was her signature song. And that song was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame back in 1999. And they released it back in 1960. And it hit number 2 on the R&B single chart and number 47 on the Billboard Hot 100. You know, that song was originally written by Mack Gordon and Harry Warren, and Glenn Miller and his orchestra recorded it and performed it with John Payne, Lynn Bari, and Pat Friday on the vocals. That was all featured in that musical film, Sun Valley Serenade, back in 1941. That song, that's an old school song, y'all, before Etta James did it. But see, when Etta signed with Lynda Chess for Chess Records, they believed her voice had that crossover pop potential and wanted her to sing to more violins and other string instruments. And it came out to be a beautiful song. It did. The way Etta did it, it was dope, man. And you know what? I thought Beyonce did a good job portraying her in the movie Cadillac Records, which is one of my favorite movies of all time. Now, Etta, she did have a problem with Beyonce singing that song for President Obama and First Lady Michelle Obama's first dance. I know at one of her shows, Etta James went on stage and said Beyonce gonna get her butt whipped because she can't stand her. And she said she had no business up there singing up there on a big old President Day, singing her song that she's been singing forever. Etta James even dissed President Obama, saying he had big ears and he wasn't her president. Wow. Etta James was off the chain. You can tell in the movie she was off the chain, man. But here's the crazy part, though. They say President Obama wanted Etta James to do it first. He even called her peoples and everything, her management team and everything, but she never called back. Then he wanted her and Beyonce to sing it together on stage as a duet at the White House, but you know, Etta never checked her voicemail or called back, so Beyonce did it by herself. But some people say Etta had dementia at the time and was hooked on pills at the time when she dissed Beyonce and Obama. I don't know. That's what they say. And it's crazy because a lot of legends, a lot of female singers, legendary ones, they be mad at Beyonce, man. I know. So I remember Aretha Franklin was mad at Beyonce because she introduced Tina Turner as the queen at the Grammys. But anyway, I'm working on that Etta James story too, which is coming soon. But you know, RIP to Etta James, true legend, you know. But anyway, back to the I Love You episode on R&B Rainstorm. Let's get into the next song. Let's see what we got. Oh man, this is my jump. 2. GQ, I Do Love You. Raining R&B.
All right.
It's just an oldie but goodie.
Shoot, shoot, shoot it up. Shoot it up. Shoot, shoot.
Like the good old days when the lady treats you so, so good. Remembering the things we used to do, the places we used to go, and everything was so, so mellow. Oh, I love the soul right now. 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 I love your soul.
Rain and R&B, R&B Rainstorm. It's your boy Bobby Flawless. Shout outs to Ground Up Radio, my man Q45. And that was the group GQ with I Do Love You. Every time I hear that song, man, I think of the movie Baby Boy at the end with Tyrese and Taraji playing cards and she pregnant. You know what's crazy about the movie Baby Boy? John Singleton actually wrote that for Tupac, he said. Could y'all imagine Tupac playing that role instead of Tyrese? That'd be crazy, man. You know, GQ, the group GQ, they from New York. I think they from the Bronx. They from the Bronx. And they came out during the disco era, though, the late 70s and everything. And they released that song back in 1979, and it hit number 5. On the US R&B charts and number 20 on the Billboard Hot 100 charts. And a lot of reggae artists remade that song, believe it or not. They love that song. You see, the original version came from Billy Stewart back in 1965. And when he released it, it hit number 6 on the US and R&B chart and number 26 on the Billboard Hot 100. I'ma do Billy Stewart's story too, because he died in a tragic car accident at 32 years old. His story is worth telling too. I love this style of singing. Billy Stewart was they call him Fat Boy. He was a beast, man. And GQ also remade Billy Stewart's Sitting in the Park. I love that song too. Now, let's get into the next song for this I Love You episode on R&B Rainstorm. Oh, man. What can you say about this song right here? Stevie Wonder, Ribbon in the Sky, R&B Rainstorm. Thank you.
But what is that was always meant is a ribbon in the sky for our love, love we can lose. With God on our side, we'll find strength in each tear we cry.
Rain and R&B, R&B Rainstorm. It's your boy Bobby Flawless, live on Ground Up Radio. Shout outs to my man Q45, Ground Up Radio CEO, making big moves 2021. That was Stevie Wonder with Ribbon in the Sky, released back in 1982. That Stevie Wonder album basically was a greatest hits album, and Ribbon in the Sky hit number 54 on the pop charts and number 10 on the R&B charts in the US. The only artist I like that remade that song and made it sound great was the group Intro. RIP the lead singer Kenny Green. You can check his story out on my channel too. Intro did a good job of remaking that song. And Ribbon in the Sky also made Essence Magazine's 25 best slow jams of all time. Stevie Wonder performed that song at Whitney Houston's funeral, and right after that he did the song Love's in Need of Love Today. I love that song too. You know what's crazy? In an interview, Quincy Jones said Stevie Wonder isn't blind. He said the same thing about Ray Charles too, but a lot of people stated that he isn't blind. Lionel Richie said it. And of course, Quincy Jones, Shaq, even Boy George said that he wasn't blind. That's crazy, man. I don't know. What y'all think? But anyway, I want to thank all y'all for tuning in for the I Love You episode on Rain and R&B, R&B Rainstorm, Rain Soul, you know. And don't forget to leave your top 5 songs list in the comments. I'm gonna need help. Like I said, I wanna do a part 2, but I got other topics and everything for the R&B Rainstorm, you know. And shout out to all my fans, supporters, Patreon supporters, all of y'all. Really love Celebrity Underrated. We're gonna take this R&B Rainstorm to another level too. And don't forget to buy and stream the new Celebrity Underrated instrumental album, Soundtrack to the Channel Volume 1. It's on all platforms right now: iTunes, Amazon, Spotify, all of that. Tidal. And once again, you know, shout outs to my man Ground Up Radio, Q45. Make sure y'all check him out on groundupradio.com. And stay tuned for the next episode, y'all. One love.